Yeah, this is about our recent result about homogeneous magnetic field. And this is for the measurement of the neutron electric dipole moment with using the ultra cold neutron. And neutron EDM violates the CP symmetry and also the time reversal invariance. And this could provide us a very stringent test for new physics beyond the standard model in the particle physics. And this could make clear the origin of the matter in the universe. And the EDM measurement needs precise observation of precession of neutron spin in controlled magnetic and electric field, so that it is important to have ultra-cold neutron in high intense ultra-cold neutron, and then it is also important to have very precise magnetic field, weak but should be very homogeneous. And the present world record of the upper limit of the neutron EDM is about 3 × 10⁻²⁶, which is provided by the Institute Rao Rangjman. And we aimed at the measurement of the neutron EDM of an order of 10⁻²⁷ centimeter. And for this kind of measurement, a very precise magnetic field of about 1 microtesla, very small, and very homogeneous magnetic field with a field gradient less than 0.1 nanotesla per meter, that's necessary. And we are now developing the automatic compensation system for destructive environmental magnetic field of about 40 microtesla. Okay, in the beginning of the universe, if the matter and antimatter is produced with the same rate, then the matters and antimatters annihilate and go back to the photons, and no matters are left. But our universe is made up of matter, practically. And baryon asymmetry, which is the ratio between baryon density and photon density, is determined by depending from the cosmic microwave background, and it is 6 × 10⁻¹. And to have the baryon synthesis in the universe, Sakharov's three conditions is necessary. Of course, the baryon number should be violated. And charge conjugation and the CP symmetry should be violated. And also, it should be away from the thermal equilibrium. And the standard model, of course, predict the CP violation. However, it's insufficient. Baryon asymmetry, which is predicted by the standard model, is about 10⁻¹⁸. It's totally insufficient. So neutrons have a magnetic moment. So if we have a time reversal transformation, then the magnetic moment is reversed. However, if neutrons have also the dipole moment, dn, then it is not reversed by the time reversal transformation, so that the neutron EDM can detect the time reversal violation. If you have only a small amount of EDM, then the time reversal is violated. So we would like to measure this neutron EDM for detecting the time reversal invariance violation. So the EDM measurement, we use Ramsey resonance technique. We will confine neutrons, polarized neutron in a cell, under the magnetic field and the strong electric field. And by applying half-pipe pulse, the neutron spin will be rotated 90 degrees. Wait a second, too much. With half-pipe pulse, it's rotated 90 degrees and to the horizontal plane. Then neutron spin precessed in the horizontal plane. And then after some time, some precession time, we will put another half-pipe pulse to rotate neutron spin again. Then the neutron spin, neutron polarization is reversed. And depending on the phase difference between the precession and the RF pulse, we can have this kind of, you know, fringing, Ramsey fringe, fringing spectrum. And if we reverse the electric magnetic electric field, if the pattern is shifted, that's you know, evidence of the existence of the EDM. And for the production of the ultra-cold neutron, we use a high-energy proton beam irradiated to the tungsten target, and using the sporation reaction, the neutron is produced. And neutrons are slowed down by the graphite moderator. And then room temperature and low temperature, heavy water. Then finally, the cold neutron downscattered by the superfluid, downscattered by the phonons in the superfluid helium-4. And the new UCN is polarized by the very strong magnetic field. Then we get this kind of Ramsey resonance, and to get very precise resonance frequency. However, the neutron spins are moving around inside the cell. So if we have inhomogeneity in the magnetic field, then the precession phase is diverse, so that the transverse relaxation time is reduced. And that gives rise to the static error, statistical error. And also, the inhomogeneity provides us some small amount of the transverse component of the magnetic field, and also the relativistic weak-loss-e term. The cross term of these two magnetic fields give us very small but very fatal false EDM effect. This could be a very serious systemic error. So that the precise magnetic field is very important. Towards the measurement of the EDM of the order of 10 to the minus 27 e centimeter, we need 1 microtesla weak magnetic field with a very small gradient. And we would like to have this kind of very homogeneous magnetic field with a compensation coil from the geomagnetism of very large amount of about 40 microtesla. And then 4 layer of magnetic shield, and the residual field should be less than 10 picotesla. And using the spherical coil, we would like to have a very homogeneous magnetic field. And today I would like to talk about the compensation coil, like this, you know.
2 minutes
left. The one set of the Helmholtz geometry coil, we will compensate the magnetic field from the outside. And also using the Wiser geometry of coils, we will compensate also the field gradient. and y, z direction and also y direction. And this is a real photo. And this is a field mapping as a function of the position. And this amount of the magnetic field is about geometric, geomagnetic field. And this is compensated. And also using another coil, we can, you know, cancel out the field gradient as well. And using this kind of automatic compensation system, we can automatically compensate the magnetic field and also the field gradient. And if we put another coil to generate a very steep field gradient, automatic compensation system worked out also. Okay. And using this kind of system, we would like to have a very precise magnetic field and aiming at the EDM measurement of the order of 10 to the minus 27th. And this is a summary. Thank you very much for your attention.